Oh, we're glitching over here. We're glitching.
I think there's been a glitch. Oh my god, and I am spilling coffee.
Hi guys.
I am so excited for today.
I need you all to know that Emily's making this video happen today.
I have been, okay, I actually have been fighting for this one. It's probably coming up 6 months. Like, it's been that long that I've been like,
100%.
I think we need to be redoing this. Mm-hmm. I think we need to be redoing this. And Bonnie's like, that's such a big job. I just don't want to do that. And I'm like,
do you know
why? We simply have to.
It's just because I'm so indecisive and I literally change my mind all the time about my favorite Taylor Swift songs.
But think about the satisfaction you will feel when you finally got a confirmed top 50 again.
There's so much pain in the process.
I don't have a top 50 right now because I'm literally so lost with all the new songs. Guys, if you didn't know, the last time we filmed this was not very long after Red Taylor's version came out. So we have not re-ranked our favorite Taylor songs since midnight. Speak Now Vault Tracks and 1989 Vault Tracks, and we really felt like we needed to do this before Tortured Poets because we're literally a year and a half on from Midnights and it's taken us this long to actually fathom how we feel about that album. So we can't wait for Tortured Poets because then we're gonna have to wait another year and a half and it's gonna be like 5 years.
We just know that there's gonna be some of the most superior songs we've ever heard on Tortured Poets.
Oh,
like
that's
there's
it.
Definitely gonna be some ones penetrating the top 10. I fear
without even hearing it we already know that it's just going to be one of those albums. It's just going to be.
It is.
Anyways, guys, so we're going to sit here with you today and we are going to be ranking every single Taylor Swift song. I actually have seen a lot of you guys message us on Instagram since we told everyone over there that we were going to be doing this, asking what sorter it is that we use. So we'll link it below in the description so that you guys can sort of play along whilst we're doing this.
Mm, yeah.
Oh, no, hold on a second. Why have you got an interesting different font?
Do I?
Oh my god, I do.
Are they fucking kidding with this first option?
Oh, I know.
Seriously going to die already.
Oh, we're just getting straight into it.
No, well, I just need to preface that.
No, I think that we are.
We are getting straight into it, but I do need to preface, guys, that I can't be held responsible for what happens here today. Like, I am simply just going to go with my gut.
No.
And I'm going to not overthink it too much because otherwise I will have a mental breakdown.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to go with my gut and, like, you know what? If it changes next time, it fucking changes next time.
Sometimes as Swifties, we put too much pressure on making sure that the rankings are perfect. And I think that we can all agree that we've, like, collectively gotten to a point where it's just, like, it almost is impossible to really rank them. Like, there's so many songs that we feel so similarly about.
Yes.
We just can't be too precious about it. Like, we've just got to do it.
You just got to do it. And you also just need to accept that, I think for me, sometimes this is going to look different. You know,
yeah.
If I'm having a moment with a song, then that's going to be in my top 50 at that time.
Yeah.
It might shift. It might change depending on my life, depending on what I'm going through, depending on what I'm relating to. Like, that just will happen for me.
Yeah.
I think that you inspired me a little bit with this. You're very good at switching up your songs when you feel like you need to.
Do you know what? You are. Mm. Guys, we've got Ducky here with us today.
Yeah.
You would know her from all of our reactions. She's always been a couch friend. Okay.
Here we fucking go.
Look, I hate to say it, but this one's easy. It's right where you left me.
You know, I just don't know if I agree.
Yep. First song, and she's already struggling.
Okay, guys, I just need to say that I've been having such a moment with Evermore lately, so I am going to say Evermore.
Fair enough. It's long story short for me.
It's long story short, but that's fucked.
I can't believe we're starting off with Evermore. That's, like, overwhelming because Evermore is our favorite album. I mean, it's Ivy.
Ooh.
You know what? I'm actually going to say Dorothea, and here's the thing. Oh, God, happiness means so much, though.
Oh, no, I'm so upset.
No, but do you know what? Somebody out here's got to pick Dorothea, and none of you are going to be picking it.
We have always talked about how a Dorothea stands.
I know.
Oh, but happiness is so life-changing.
I mean, it is. I understand.
I think I'm going to have to pick happiness.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just doing it.
Yeah, just do it. It's Nobody, No Crime.
For me, it's Tolerated.
Okay, fine. It's Champagne Problems.
It's Champagne Problems.
Oh, Fearless. Okay. You're not sorry. I mean, you know how the cells in my legs feel about You're Not Sorry.
For me, it's You Belong With Me.
Yeah, great.
Oh, you're
we're really.
Me.
Wait! They're really switching things up.
I know, but that's fucked up. I it's love you're losing me.
I am so excited to see where You're Losing Me falls onto this ranking for me, because I fucking love that song. Same. Like, I actually think it might be one of the best songs she's ever written, but I... Will it make the top 10? I don't know.
I think it's going to make the top 10 for me.
Okay, I love that. Oh, it's Wildest Dreams.
It's Wildest Dreams. It is. Ooh. Oh, you guys are going to hate me for this. I'm going to cause some enemies, but it's Welcome to New York.
I actually think that I do prefer White Horse, so I'm going to go White Horse.
I think that that's right for you.
And I am going to go The Way I Loved You, because it's The Way I Loved You.
Yeah, you know, I think I am too. You know, I really it is my favorite song. Used to love Untouchable, and then something happened where it just stopped becoming one of my favorites on Fearless, and I don't know why. Anyway, it's The Way I Loved You.
Yeah.
Tim McGraw.
Oh, this for me it's love. This love.
Oh,
what do you know?
That one's hard.
I actually...
Sweeter Than Fiction or Teardrops on My Guitar?
It's Teardrops on My Guitar for me. So I'm just going to go there.
I think it's Sweeter Than Fiction for me.
This next one is Rude and Criminal to the Soul.
This is really quite okay, rude and criminal.
Okay, we might just be the only living Superman and Superstar stans on this planet. Like, those two songs are, like, consistently in people's, like, bottom 10 favorite songs. Like, no one listens to either of these songs, and they're both... So good!
I think it for me it might be Superstar. Are you gonna pick Superman? Because I think that's okay.
I think it's Superman for me. Just. And then it simply is the story of us. It's do you know what? It is Red, but Sad, Beautiful, Tragic is a absolutely criminal song to be existing in this world.
It's Red. But I just want to tell people how I feel.
Yep, sure. I remember I came to you
a few years ago and I was like, Sad, Beautiful, Tragic just doesn't really do much for me. And you were like, you're wrong. And I was like, okay.
I
went away and I had such a moment with it. Like, I think it was actually a gloomy, depressing week.
Sure.
And I had a moment with it. And I was driving everywhere. I was listening to it. And I was like, this song is so beautiful. Oh my God, what the fuck is happening?
It was so necessary that you had that part of me. Anyway. It's Picture to Burn.
A perfectly good Perfectly Good Heart is not really gonna win any.
And if you have watched this from a couple of years ago, that opinion for me has not changed.
No.
I will say that just as a song to listen to, I have realized that A Perfectly Good Heart does have it's got a bit of a groove, it's fine. It's still at the bottom for me, though. Like, I just... Yeah. No, I just...
And Picture to Burn's a fucking bop.
Oh.
The last time and last kiss. The fuck? You know, it's these kind of middle songs for me that I'm like...
That's where it gets difficult.
What do you want me to do about this?
So, this is where I start implementing the you just need to make a decision, bitch. Yeah. for myself, not for you.
Okay. Thank you for clarifying.
For me... I think that I'm gonna have to base this decision off the fact that I listened to The Last Time more than I listened to Last Kiss, because Last Kiss is just so heartbreaking.
But Last Kiss it's the last time. Fucked up song. Oh my God, when you need that song, it just delivers in such a superior way. But The Last Time is, I mean, we are the Last Time stands.
I know.
So it has to be The Last Time.
Ooh. Do you know what? This might be the first one where you actually might hit no opinion.
Yeah, you literally. Hey Stephen and Holy Ground.
For me, it's Hey Stephen.
Yeah, I think it...
Hey Stephen has always been consistently at a top of a Fearless ranking for me than Holy Ground. And I think that a lot of you will be really offended by that. I feel like Holy Ground is one of those real fan favorites that people absolutely love it to death. And if I'm completely honest, I've just never felt that way about Holy Ground. It's never been my song.
No, and yes, that makes a lot of sense for you. I think that if it's the live version of her
now,
performing it at
BBC Radio 1 during Lover Era, now that version of it, that did something to me.
I honestly do I have to pick it for the sheer sake of what it can be and what it becomes?
Yeah, sure, because it's still that song.
Yeah.
It's still that song.
I don't know. Oh, God, I love Hazy.
I mean, I will be ranking My Tears Ricochet with the Long Pond Studio Sessions version in my mind. Because the fact that it can be that version, I mean, don't get me wrong, the original's great, but you know.
Back when you fit in my poem like a perfect rhyme.
Sometimes a live version just hits harder and it makes you hear what she's doing in a way that you couldn't before.
I think I'm going to pick Holy Ground, and that's a lot.
For me, it is just simply Begin Again. Begin Again on the best day. Like, the best day is great, but it for me, it's Begin Again.
You guys know I'm the best day stan.
Oh, that reminds me. Parents. Scott, if you're here, thank you for the merch. Scott, thank you for the merch. Thank you for the merch. I just Scott, need to make sure that message is loud and clear. Thank you, Scott, for the merch.
I want to die. And I want to die, but I'm going to pick Begin Again.
Wow! Yeah. That really surprises me.
Oh, I love
because
Begin Again.
Because, I mean, I know that you do, but I feel like I've heard you talk so much more about your love for The Best Day.
I know,
so
but
I'm
I think
surprised.
On Fearless, The Best Day is, like, top three for me.
But it's not, like, actually...
But then overall, I probably would rather have Begin Again for the rest of my life.
Oh, all you had to do was stay!
I think I'm going
to
offend you.
All you have to do is stay is always, always in the top 10. I'm so sorry. But
I'm going to offend you. I think I'm going to pick Mr. Perfectly Fine.
Okay. It's All Too Well.
Absolutely.
And it's... Ooh. Okay. So this... we need to talk to you guys about something.
Have we told the YouTube?
I think we've only told Patreon. So funnily enough, we both feel this way, which was a surprise to both of us. Something's happened to Call It What You Want for us since we found out about the toe breakup. And I think that...
I hate it when you call them toe.
Toe. And you know what? There's so many songs that are about their relationship. And every single one of them I will listen to, like, and I don't necessarily think about that when I'm listening to it, or like their relationship. I apply it to my own experiences or whatever. There's something about Call It What You Want for us both that is just so intrinsically tied into what that time was for her and how Joe helped her get through it, that it's like it's a bit painful to listen to these days. And it's not that we don't love it as a song, like that hasn't changed, but its listenability I think has really changed for us. That aside, I consistently listen to New Year's Day more than I listen to Call It What You Want,
and
so I will be picking New Year's Day anyway.
It's constantly grown for me, I think, as a song. I just think it's such a beautiful song, beautiful metaphor. There's just nothing that I feel like it will never age. Like,
no,
it's
just I completely agree.
This beautiful song.
New Year's Day has been such a grower for me over the years. I think when Rep first came out, like I honestly kind of could have taken it or leaving it.
Leaving?
But yeah, absolutely. Over the years, it's become one of my favorites.
Yeah.
It just hits different.
It does.
Don't know what it is about New Year's Day. I love it.
So
anyway.
Good. Oh, King
for
of My
me,
Heart.
For me, it's so, so deeply King of My Heart.
And Dancing with Our Hands Tied, I agree. King of My Heart. Oh, So It Goes and Gorgeous. Oh, this is a hard one.
Oh, it's not for me. It's Gorgeous.
I feel like I have moments with both of them, but I think overall Gorgeous does come out on top.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, that's just daylight.
Oh, False God and Afterglow. You know, I've always been an Afterglow girly, but False God is like such a good song.
I think we've really, really, really had a deep, deep fathoming of False God again ever since the toe breakup. I think that everybody's now kind of really fathoming with the recent Tortured Poets playlist that have come out, and Taylor putting False God on the Delulu playlist. False God was one of those songs that we had kind of already fathomed was Delulu, and I think it really has helped us appreciate it.
We have. You know, I'm actually just going to be a little bit unhinged and pick False God.
You know what? Me too.
Wow.
And that surprises me.
Wow,
that surprises even me.
That's amazing.
Now, hold on a second. Death by a Thousand Cuts and London Boy? These are the songs on Lover, but it is Death by a Thousand Cuts.
Yeah, for me,
I don't feel
that way about London Boy, but yes,
no,
it's Death
don't.
By a Thousand Cuts.
It's Paper Rings.
It's definitely Paper Rings. Ooh, you know...
For me, it's I Think He Knows.
For me, you know, I'm going to be so rogue.
And you're going to go The Man.
I'm going to pick The Man.
Yeah, all right.
I don't know, The Man just like... Thank fucking God she wrote that song. I know some of you bitches don't appreciate it, but I do.
I
am the man stan.
No, here's the thing. I don't not appreciate the man and what it stands for and what it is. I think it's a fucking slay and it's so necessary for Taylor to have in her discography. Do I want to listen to it all the time? No. See, definitely
I
not.
I need to be an empowered woman.
Yeah, okay.
Quite often.
Yeah. And you need to be multiple empowered women.
I do. I need to be
empowered women.
I do.
No, this is so hard. Hoax and ready for it.
Yeah, see, for me, it's ready for it.
I think that...
You do really like Ready For It.
I love Ready For It. I also love Hoax.
Do you need to play them?
It's Hoax. I'm so sorry.
You're not going to play Ready For It?
No, I just know. Hoax does something to my soul.
Betty and Epiphany.
I mean, it's Betty.
It's definitely Betty. Yeah.
Oh, ooh. Invisible String and Mad Woman.
You know, Invisible String is such an interesting one for me. Once again, like, I feel like when the album Folklore first came out, I loved Invisible String. And then just over time, I'm just like, it's not the song on Folklore that I need in my bones. But Mad Woman, I do often need Mad Woman. Once again, I have frustration towards the world.
Yeah.
So I'm going to pick Mad Woman.
I'm going to pick Invisible String.
That makes sense.
It's Illicit Affairs.
I think it... Oh, God. This Is Me Trying and Illicit Affairs.
I mean, This Is Me Trying is totally up there, but I think Illicit Affairs, I just, like, I can't deny how I feel about that song. And you know what? That's also been a huge grower for me. I actually wasn't a huge Illicit Affairs stan when Folklore first came out, and something's happened.
This hurts in the soul. It hurts in the being. I like them both.
Yep. Well, maybe you need to be thinking I like both.
I think I am.
Go off.
No, don't do this to this person. Mirable and Seven are always the ones battling it out for fifth place in my Folklore ranking.
For me, it's Mirable, so I'm just going to click that right now.
That's just so offensive that you can make that decision so quickly because I'm in the need.
I mean, like, what is Mirable is Mirable.
I know, but Seven is my song.
I know. Oh, well, maybe you need to go I Like Both again.
No, I really do need to pick between them. I just don't know what to do.
Maybe you need to listen.
Sorry. I need the chorus. I think it is Mirable, but like Seven is just also the fucking outro. This is all I need in life.
Yeah, I get that.
You know, it's Mirable by like I need you all to know it's Mirable by a fraction of a hair. Oh, it's My Tears Ricochet.
It is.
Cardigan and the One.
It's Cardigan.
It's all too well.
It is always. And now it is always All Too Well, the 10-minute version. It is always All Too Well, the 10-minute version. Any battle, yeah. It is always All Too Well, the 10-minute version.
Absolutely.
Just need to get that out there. Now, for me, this one is a really simple Forever Winter.
Yes, I think it is for me too. Oh, it's Babe.
It is Babe. Oh, I don't like this one. I don't like this one. Dear Reader and Better Man. If I'm completely honest with myself, it is Better Man, I'm going to go Better Man.
I think I'm going to go Dear Reader.
Cool. It's high infidelity. It's high infidelity.
Absolutely.
Oh my God, I'm so happy to be ranking Midnight Songs.
Oh, I think it's Paris. We were in Paris.
It's Paris. So we had Paris. Do you know like, what? So many me? People drag Paris, and for us, it will always hold such a special place because we were in Paris reacting to Midnight.
That chorus, every time I hear the chorus of Paris, I'm in Paris.
I am immediately back there. Guys, the night of the Midnight's release, we had arguably the greatest night of our entire lives. We spent the entire day filming our reaction to Midnights, and then Bonnie's friend Ashley flew into Paris that afternoon.
The same iconic Ashley that we went to see before we got our last tickets to the Eras tour.
Yes.
Ashley is like...
Ashley makes things happen
for us.
You guys
have never met Ashley, but she just makes it happen. Like, she brings the party. And she just brought the party that night. She was like...
She did, guys.
We're going out.
She flew in that afternoon and came to our Airbnb. And then she'd never been to Paris before. So we were like, we need to be going out. And we... quite literally had a bottle of rosé and we're frolicking under the Eiffel Tower, waiting for every hour on the hour when it would shimmer. Sparkle. And
oh, we were doing some unhinged things.
We were just literally just running around, like, honestly, wine drunk in Paris. And it was the greatest night of our life. And Paris, the song, reminds us of that night.
We were just playing it on repeat as we were running around the city.
Yeah.
At one point, there was cartwheels.
There was. There was cartwheels at one point. There really was. And then we went up to that... If you guys have been to Paris, you probably know what I'm talking about. You know, like when you kind of go like away from the Eiffel Tower and then you go up those stairs and there's like a platform at the top that kind of takes you to another road.
Oh, and everyone was dancing there?
Everybody was dancing.
Oh my God. And then that guy was busking and we were trying to get him to play Taylor
Swift. And he played Love Story.
Yes, he played Love Story. This busker. And like, oh my God, it was so chaotic.
It was such a good night though. Anyway.
Yeah, best night ever.
Now, this girly right here is a question Stan. It is question without question.
I'm going to also be the advocate for angry women again.
Yeah.
And pick vigilante
shit. You're surprising me because normally I'm the one to go for angry songs. Yeah. And you're really going.
Yeah, you're right. It's your on your own
kid. It's
actually always going to be.
It's always going to be your on your own kid. What the fuck did you just do?
Oh, I just did something.
Okay, well, apparently you just kicked snow on the
No, 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 no. How do I go back? Oh my God, I kicked it over anti-hero.
You can't go back.
No.
That's okay. No. You'll have plenty more opportunities to be picking anti-hero against other things.
Oh, I love anti-heroes.
Like, you would hope that you're going to make a mistake on one that you don't really give a fuck about.
I just double-clicked that shit. I was so passionate about You're On Your Own, Kid. It just kept going.
Well, how about I pick anti-hero? Because I do think, for me, it's anti-hero over Snow on the Beach.
Oh, really?
And
I'm so proud of you.
Yeah, I think it is. It is simply Maroon.
Simply Maroon.
Don't. Timeless. It just is timeless. Yeah. It's timeless.
Ooh,
it's foolish one. It's when Emma falls in love.
It's when Emma falls in love.
It's Now That We Don't Talk.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
Is it over now?
It is.
Oh my God, it's so deeply we say don't go.
Evermore, and it's time.
No, we're different now.
Oh, we're different. Oh, because I've gotten.
Yes. Oh. I do prefer, I have Right Where You Left Me and It's Time to Go. And for me, I do prefer Right Where You Left Me just slightly, but we do both love It's Time to Go.
We do.
What a healing song.
What a healing song. Very necessary.
But Evermore is also
soul.
A healing song.
I know.
So.
I know. I think I'm going to pick Evermore because I'm on that bandwagon today. I've chosen my path.
Yeah. We've just done a little switcheroo. Okay. Oh.
I'm also going to pick Right Where You Left Me.
So what happens if I pick It's Time to Go over Evermore?
I don't know, really. That's just a bit insulting. I don't think you feel that way.
Do I not?
No, I don't think that you do. I mean...
I think that I do.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I think I might need to do my first I Like Both. Okay. I really can't decide between those two.
Okay, fine. Oh, now we're back on the same
track. Okay, good. It's so deeply long story short. And it's deeply Marjorie.
Oh, it's Ivy.
It is Ivy, but we both love Cowboy Like Me.
Yeah. This is a question I never wish to ever be presented with in my entire life.
Yeah.
Coney Island versus Cowboy Like Me.
Yeah, that's hard.
What does a girl do with that?
I think, once again, if I'm being honest with myself, it is Cowboy Like Me just a little.
I think it is.
By you just know, a little bit, it
Cowboy
is.
Cowboy Like Me actually makes me want to cry.
Truly.
No one gets Cowboy Like Me, like us.
No, and do you know what? It really is heightened by the knowledge that it's Marcus Mumford in the background. I'm so sorry, but
it just is. Absolutely, and it's just the best sound she's ever done. Like, what is even happening there?
Nothing sounds like Cowboy Like Me. No, it's Cowboy Like Me. It just is.
Happiness and Tolerate It. You know, I think I've always been a happiness stan over Tolerate It, and I don't know. I think it's happy. Yeah, I think it's happiness. Yeah.
So I actually have Nobody, No Crime and Dorothea. And that's certainly difficult.
That is difficult. I think it might be Nobody, No Crime, though.
But I actually listened to Dorothea more.
Oh, she's gonna be Dorothea.
You know, Dorothea is a song for me that no matter what the energy of life is, I will never skip Dorothea. I'm always ready to listen to it. Whereas, like, there are definitely days where I'm like, I don't feel like listening to about a murder. So I'm gonna go Dorothea.
Yeah, you know, it's so... I've got Tolerate It Now and Dorothea. Yeah. And, like, even though I think that Tolerate It is the best bridge she's ever written, I do listen to Dorothea more because, like you just said, like, it just makes me so happy. It makes me feel so good. And, you know... Oh, but Tolerate It. I'm just going to be so rogue, hey, and pick Dorothea.
Yeah.
Oh, how curious. Yeah, okay.
We have different feeler songs here. For me, I think it is... I think it's Willow.
Is it? Oh my God, I did not expect that.
I mean, You're Not Sorry. I know. I do feel quite strongly about You're Not Sorry.
Yeah, you do. Like, you always just randomly...
Do you know what? I actually think you're right. I actually think you're right. I do think that, like, when I look at feelers, I feel stronger about You're Not Sorry than I do about Willow on Evermore. I think it is You're Not Sorry. Thank you for correcting my brain. Oh, and now I've got the same one.
I don't understand how I'm supposed to choose between these. Like, they just... You Belong With Me and Willow. Like, You Belong With Me is the most classic bop I've ever heard in my entire life. Willow is, like, the opening of Evermore. Like,
and arguably, one could argue it's one of the greatest songs she's ever written. I'm so sorry.
Willow?
But it is, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they both are.
Yeah, they are. You're right. I think it's Willow, though.
But, like, You Belong With Me. Okay, fine, I'll pick Willow.
I think it's Willow.
I don't feel good about it. I just don't feel good about it.
Oh. Now, do you know what? It is You're Losing Me, but we do love Hits Different.
Hits Different is so superior. Oh my God, You Are In Love and Hits Different?
That's hard. That is hard.
I think I need you to play them.
Oh God, here we go. Guys, fun fact about me, I get the hiccups every single day.
Yeah, it's actually surprising that you don't get it more in a video, actually.
I know. Every single day, I'm not even exaggerating. Every single day I have the hiccups at least once or twice.
What is up with that?
I don't know. I lost my hands of voice at the club. You made a mess of me.
I picture you with other girls. I'm not happy. In love. Not happy. Threw up on the street. No.
I'm picking Hits Different.
I think that I'm just in a You Are In Love phase.
Okay.
So I think I'm going to pick You Are In Love, but
cool.
This is hurting me. Don't hold it against me.
Ooh, oh.
This love and Tied Together With a Smile. This love.
It is, but I need you to know how much I love Tied Together With a Smile. I am so excited for Taylor's version. It is one of my favorite songs on debut.
The Story I of Us
hate this.
And Style.
This might be my most hated one so far.
Yeah.
What do you mean? The Story of Us is like one of like my songs.
Yes, it is. I think that like, I think The Story of Us for you.
But style.
For me, it's definitely Style, so I'm going to do that.
I think it is The Story of Us for me.
Mm, I think it is.
That's really awful to say. I know it is awful. But
it's truly awful.
I will never get over what The Story of Us does to me. Oh.
Oh, I have State of Grace and Starlight, and it's State of Grace. State of Grace is probably my favorite song on Red, apart from All Too Well. The Last Time and Long Live. Long Live.
I mean, it is Long Live. It just is. Oh, it's Jump and Fall.
I wish you would.
I know places.
I almost do, and I Knew You Were Trouble.
I think that I have to be real. It's I Knew You Were Trouble. I am obsessed with that song.
How You Get the Girl? Oh, I've got Holy Ground.
I've got Hey Steven. It's How You Get the Girl.
You
for
love
me.
How You Get the Girl. I think for me, it's Holy Ground. I'm so sorry. Oh, it's Hey Steven. Haunted and Forever and Always piano version.
It is Haunted for me.
It's Forever and Always piano version. I mean, I do have a Falamingo. Shit. No, I can't pick it over Forever and Always piano version.
Yeah, can I? Right. I don't know. I guess that probably does make sense for you. Yeah.
Like, I understand. The fact that I'm even considering this shows
it's a
my
lot.
Growth.
It's a lot. I you're right.
I think it is Forever and Always piano version, but like, oh, yeah. Now I'm going to be Haunted. Hey, look at me go.
For me here, it is Forever and Always. And I think for you, it's going to be Fearless.
For me, it's Fearless. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, and then I'll go Forever and Always.
I've got Fearless and 15, and it is Fearless.
Thank you.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, I've got this too. You know, 15 and Eyes Open.
It's 15 for me.
Keep your eyes open. You know, when she mashed up 15 and You're on Your Own Kid, I had a bit of a moment there. So yeah. I'm going to pick 15.
Cool. Oh, for me, it's Enchanted. That's an obvious one.
I'm so sorry.
And while we're here, I'll pick Dear John too.
This is deeply
confusing. I know. This is a hard one for you.
Enchanted and Everything Has Changed. Like, Enchanted is Enchanted, but like, so like, you know, Enchanted is like, but like Everything Has Changed is like my little song that I just secretly like listen to all the time.
Yeah.
Like, it feels like mine.
Yeah. I envision it as one of your songs, yeah.
And I love it so much.
It is, like, it is definitively her best collaboration with Ed Sheeran. Like, I'm absolutely, so yes. Sorry of all the songs that we have of them together, which four at this stage.
This is definitely their best song. But can I pick it over Enchanted? That's just... I don't know if I can. That's really hard. I really don't know which song.
Well, maybe you need to go I Like Both here.
I think I will for now, and maybe the next time it comes around, it will just be
It'll
easier.
It'll come to you.
Oh, it's Clean.
It's Clean!
Ooh, how curious. Blank
no, it's
begin
again for
again.
Me. It just simply is. Oh, and then, you know, while I'm here, I know that the next one's Blank Space. Thank you.
I hate this. I love Blank Space. God, I love Blank Space. But at Begin Again is just so good. I think it's going to be Blank Space.
Yeah.
And then it's Begin Again.
Yeah. And then now we've got the same ones and it is The Best Day.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you.
And it is back to December. Do you know what? I actually might pick Beautiful Eyes.
I think it's Bad Blood for me.
Yeah, Bad Blood is a bit of a bop.
Only because
though,
I just
it?
Don't listen to Beautiful Eyes. Like, maybe I'll have a fathoming if she puts
it
as a vault.
I actually only think that there's a live version of it on Spotify as well. Like, they don't even have the recorded version.
I just haven't really fathomed it, to be honest.
Beautiful Eyes, stare at it. No, it is Bad Blood. I'm sorry. But yeah. It just is.
Thank you. Ooh.
It's That's When.
That's When.
Oh, for me, it's Don't
I
You. I love Don't You.
Although I was more bad.
There is something about the vibe of Don't You.
What's the lyric you don't like in Bye Bye?
It's not Bye Bye Baby.
Oh, it's not. No,
it's We're happy.
I think for me, it's Bye Bye Baby.
Well, mine is All You Had to Do Was Stay. Like, I mean, it doesn't matter what song was next to it. Unless it was All Too Well 10, it is All You Had to Do Was Stay. Yeah. But. You know, most things are going to go above We Were Happy for me.
Mr. Perfectly Fine.
Yeah, I've got that now too, and I'm definitely going to
I will put All You Had to Do Is Stay above We Were Happy.
Thank you so much.
Ooh.
Now, do we need to be considering the fact that, like, All Too Well 10 is All Too Well 10 and that's on here as a separate song?
Can we just, like, not include All Too Well, the
five-minute
version? I find
it difficult because I do think that the normal version has a place because the production is so different and its build is perfect. I think that... You know, there's something about having the 10-minute version that, like, even though that is, like, kind of the only version that I listen to these days, I do think that having the 10-minute version really helps me appreciate how perfectly she cut it down.
I agree.
To the version of All Too Well that is our original.
It's such a perfect song, the original, but I also just don't know where to put it amongst the other songs?
No, like, I kind of don't want to have, like, All Too Well 10 in my ranking and then also have All Too Well in, like, my top 15 because I don't feel that way.
Yeah, and then you're just giving spots to a song.
Maybe we need to be making an executive decision that when it's normal All Too Well, we just have to pick the other song. Unless we really just don't feel that way.
Because in my mind, All Too Well is just number one and it's both the 10-minute version and the original for different reasons. And, like, I don't want to pin them against each other.
No, but All Too Well 10 will
Be the representative.
I think I am going to go New Year's Day. Like, yeah. I think if I'm thinking about it, maybe with All Too Well, I need to just be considering the fact that, like, because I don't listen to it that much anymore because of the 10-minute version, I'll go with the song that I do listen to more, which in this case is absolutely New Year's Day.
I agree.
Like, you know, if it was, you know, fucking Eyes Open and All Too Well, I'm obviously going to pick All Too Well. But, you know, like, you know.
Call it what you want, I guess, then.
It's Call It What You Want, yeah. Now, for me, that's King of My Heart.
Yeah, I think it is for me too. But Dress is a deeply superior song.
It is.
And it's been rising on my list of what I rep. I think, like,
Dress, it, like, that fucking bridge, though. Do you know what? I have my next one too. It's Dancing With Our Hands Tied and Dress, and it is Dress. I'm just going to pick Dress while we're here.
I'm just miserable. I'm going to pick Dress. Just don't talk to me about it.
No, that's fine.
I'm going to
be This one is Getaway Car for both of us.
Obviously Getaway Car. Obviously Delicate.
It is Delicate.
Obviously Don't Blame Me.
For me, it's Look What You Made Me Do.
The fuck?
Guys, I don't really fathom
Guys,
Don't Blame Me.
Can you please bully Emily into fathoming Don't Blame Me?
If you had to wait to fathom Haunted for Speak Now Taylor's version, then I will wait for Rep TV to fathom
I just
don't blame
like,
me.
What is there not to fathom, you know?
It's
like,
just not, like, it's not, like, my favourite sound.
But Look What You Made Me Do is?
Yeah, Look What You Made Me Do is a fucking bop. Hell, what the hell? And it's August.
It's August.
It's always August.
Oh, it's My Tears Ricochet.
It is.
Oh, Exile in the Lakes. Now, we do love the lakes.
Do you know what? I actually am going to go the lakes because I just think that the vibe of the lakes just, like, it transports me to a life that I feel I should have lived.
Yes, I understand.
Which is, you know...
You know,
it's like late 18th century Jane Austen frolicking in the English countryside with a little book.
I just can't get over how I think it's the best song she's ever written. I think that I'm going to pick The Lakes as well, which I know is going to really offend a lot of you Exile stans out there.
I know.
But I think that I've said this before, but I think that I have a bit of, like, resentment towards Exile, and it's because I, like, the rest of the world was like, oh my God, Exile, like, Taylor Swift can finally do something good. And it's like,
yeah.
No?
Yeah, I
like,
think
she
that
doesn't need Bonavir to be
many,
deeply superior.
Too many people decided that Taylor Swift was listenable because she did a song with Bonavir.
Yeah.
And that doesn't sit right with me.
No.
And that is not Exile's fault. It's not Taylor's fault. And it's not Bonavir's fault. It's actually the masses' fault.
It is.
And I think for that reason, there's something about it that I'm just like, I love Exile. Don't get me wrong. The actual song itself is fucking perfection.
It's
a beautiful song. It's specifically the human who would have bashed her during rep era and then it's like, oh, she did a song with one of them. Oh my God, I can listen to her now. Like, that's so illegal to me. You were that motherfucker on Twitter hashtagging Taylor Swift is over party.
Yeah, and now
it's,
you like
if you were that breed of human, it's you who has made me upset.
Yeah, I completely agree. So therefore, it has to be The Lakes, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Ooh, Cardigan.
It's Cardigan. But we do love The Last Great American Dynasty! And I am going The Last Great American Dynasty next.
Yes,
as well.
Yep.
It's All Too Well 10!
I've got Run in the very first night, and I'm going to be the first person to say Run.
Yeah. And you may always be the very first person to say Run.
Run is pretty.
It is pretty. It just doesn't do a lot for me.
It.
I don't hate it.
No,
there is not one single Taylor Swift song that I won't listen to.
No,
like,
I agree.
And let us make that very clear.
Yes.
Like, we can say, oh, you know, like, whatever, doesn't really do a lot for me. It's still a better song than most artists are capable of. And we love it in a way that we don't love most other artists' music, but we are here ranking, so something has to go down the bottom.
Taylor Swift can't write a bad song.
She can't. Now, high infidelity, would've, could've, should've. That should objectively be a really difficult choice would've, could've, should've is definitely like top three on midnights for me. But high infidelity does something to me.
Is high infidelity still like your number one?
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is about high infidelity. The way that song makes me feel, it's just so different to anything that she's ever written. Like, I think sound-wise, nothing sounds like high infidelity for me. And so nothing makes me feel the way that high infidelity feels. And Woulda, Coulda, Shoulda is a fucking masterpiece. Like, it's probably, like, number two on Midnights for me. Like, these are my favorites.
Yeah.
But high infidelity, man, I don't know what the fuck she put in that
song. No, I get it, because, like, I think that Woulda, Coulda, Shoulda is, like, it is a more important song to me, but I listen to High Infidelity more often.
Yeah, interesting.
Like, I feel like I'm always in the mood for High Infidelity. Like, it's just so good. It's such good lyrics and storytelling, and it's so unpredictable. And I totally get you on High Infidelity, but I think I'm going to pick Woulda, Coulda, Shoulda just for the plot.
Yep, I get that. Oh, we've switched it up. I've got Glitch and Would've, Could've, Should've, and it is Would've, Could've, Should've. Mm. And, you know, I think that I'm going to take this opportunity to let you guys know that I think that I have decided that Glitch doesn't do a lot for me.
Okay.
I feel like every time it comes on, I'm like, oh, yeah.
Mm.
You know, I think for me, there's something in it that, like, I feel like the absolute height of her Delulu. Yeah, and I'm like, it. I don't believe you. There's something about even like the way that she's singing Glitch that I'm like, I don't believe you.
I think that just confuses me a little bit. Like, I'm not really sure how we got to this song at this point.
I don't believe it. Because she's like, it's meant to be, I think, like, you know, like, oh, there's been a glitch. Like, we've been together for 6 years. Like, oh my God, kind of love you. Like, we were supposed to be the friends. And like, that's fun. I think that it's great that like, there are probably a lot of people who can really relate to that. Like, oh wow, like I thought we were just a fling and now I've ended up together and you're the love of my life. But I do not believe that Taylor recording that song was a version of Taylor who believed, oh my God, we've been together for 6 years. You're the love of my life. Oh my God. Wait, I've just fathomed something. This sorta has featuring Lana and featuring more Lana.
Oh no. Okay, well, I'm going to pick the more Lana one and I'm going to disregard the other Lana one.
My current selection here is Midnight Rain versus more Lana.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to go more Lana over Midnight Rain.
I think that you do like it overall.
Yeah, more. I think you're probably right.
Oh, well, hopefully I get anti-hero soon, but I'm going to go Maroon.
Yeah, I'm going Maroon. I don't even know why I sat and thought about that. I didn't need to do that.
Okay, so now I've still got the normal feature of Lana Del Rey. Sure. So I'm going to just ignore that one and pick every other song. So it's going to be All of the Girls You Loved Before.
Sure. I've got All of the Girls You Loved Before and Anti-Hero, and I'm going to go Anti-Hero.
Can I just say that it didn't give me Anti-Hero in that because I picked Lana Del Rey, Snow on the Beach last time. So now I'm actually terrified it's never going to give me Anti-Hero again.
Oh no, it will give you Anti-Hero again. It just won't be against
those songs
again, because you've already done that. I've got what I think you just had, which is Snow on the Beach regular version and All of the Girls You Loved Before. So I'll go All of the Girls.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, cool. It's Timeless. Oh, it's Lavender Haze. It's Whenever Falls in Love.
Ooh, for me it's I Can See.
And for me it's Foolish One.
Mm. Ooh, Now That We Don't Talk and Electric Touch. Oh, that's interesting.
That is interesting. Wow.
I'm gonna do Now That We Don't Talk.
Cool. I've got I Can See You and Castles Crumbling, and I'm going to go I Can See You. Mm. Oh, okay.
You do love Electric Touch.
I love both of these songs so much. That's so hard. I do think that the build in Electric Touch is maybe the only thing that I'm gonna pick Electric Touch over Now That We Don't Talk, but that's... I really... really hate doing that, and I simply need to be stressing that, because Now That We Don't Talk is a fucking perfect song. I'm so sorry.
Oh, you got those. Okay, I'm gonna go, so I got Suburban Legends and Electric Touch. I'm gonna go Electric Touch.
Nice. Oh, now we've got the same ones. Now this is hard.
It is, but for me it is over. Is it over now?
I think for me it's Say Don't Go. Just it Say Don't Go first, and then did something to me from the second that we heard it, and it's not changed. So I think I do have to say Don't Go. Oh, I mean, I will pick most things over 22, so I'm gonna go Is It Over Now.
I have Say Don't Go and Slut, and I'm going to pick Say Don't Go, but God, I love Slut. And then it's going to be
Slut. It's going to be Slut, yeah.
For me, this is Treacherous.
No, this is actually, I feel physically ill. The way I loved you and Treacherous, I don't, no, I need to listen.
Oh, Treacherous is such a good song.
Treacherous is such a good song, but please, then like please this pick exists. Treacherous.
Please, please. Isn't this your favorite song on Fearless? It's the way I loved you.
I hate this one. I hate this so much.
Yeah, I know. Some of them actually just hurt the soul.
I think I just need to clue. I'm going to go The Way I Loved You, but yeah. I already disagree with myself. Like, yeah. I just don't even know. And then I actually will say You're Treacherous.
Yeah, lovely.
Let me come back to you. Oh, we've got the same.
It's Tim McGraw.
I mean, is it?
I think it might be Tim McGraw for me. We are never, ever, ever.
I think about
back together. Fuck,
it's what We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together did to me when she released it as like the lead single from Red. Like, and obviously she did that before Red came out. So like for a hot minute there, it was like just that song. And I fucking pounded that repeat button. Like, I was so obsessed with this song. I think I'm actually gonna go We're Never Getting Back Together.
That's what's so hard about these kind of combos though, because I feel like the singles ruled my life for a different reason, but then it's like, which is the better song, you know? Like Tim McGraw
is a great song.
A great song, but We're Never Getting Back Together just is like, it is that bitch. So like, it's really hard for me to rank like iconicness versus like the better song.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to pick Tim McGraw. Today is just the day I'm feeling it. Yeah. Today was a fairy tale. I'm going to pick We're Never Getting Back Together.
I've got Tim McGraw and Untouchable currently. And that one's a tricky one. But I think I'm going to go Tim McGraw.
I think you should, yeah. You know, Today was a fairy tale and The Way I Loved You. And obviously we just played The Way I Love You and it is such a great song. But like, I just love Today was a fairy tale. I can't know which one. Today was a fairy tale, such a bop.
Oh my god, like I agree, but like if you pick Today was a fairy tale over The Way I Loved You, that is today something I so deeply cannot relate to.
Oh, I love Today Was a Fairy Tale, but I think I am gonna pick The Way I Loved You.
Thank you. I have got Today Was a Fairy Tale and Untouchable, and I'm picking Untouchable. Ooh. You have the same.
I'm gonna pick Today Was a Fairy Tale. Okay, who am I? What is happening?
Okay, I've got Mean and Our Song, and how dare this sort of make me pick between these two songs, because I love both of them so deeply.
Yeah.
Do you know what? They both go so fucking hard.
They do.
Mean and Our Song? No. I think it's Mean, though.
I think it's Mean here.
I am obsessed with Mean. Okay.
I have The Outside and A Perfectly Good Heart, and I'm just always not going to pick A Perfectly Good Heart.
Thank you so much. Yeah. We both have mine. I've got Our Song and you've got New Romantics. For me, I am going to pick Our Song over mine.
I think I might need to play these ones.
Sure. What would you like first?
New Romantics.
It's poker. You can't see it in my face, but I'm about to play my ace. 2:30 a.m.
I'm going to be honest, I would have thought that you would pick New Romantics.
Okay, good. That makes me feel better because I think I do slightly want to pick New Romantics. Yeah.
Now hold on a fucking second. I didn't want this one, same as you. What the hell?
It's hard, isn't it?
No, it actually really is. I think that I love New Romantics.
I know.
But I do think I might pick mine.
Oh, God. Go on then.
I think... Hey, You struggled too.
No, I get it. No, I. That's why I'm not judging. I get it. It's a fucked up choice.
Yeah.
For me, it's Long Live. It is Long Live. And so is it for you.
Yeah.
Love Story in the Last Time.
Oh. You know, Love Story obviously is a classic, but I do love The Last Time. I'm going to pick The Last Time.
I think I am too. Ooh, Last Kiss and Love Story. What the fuck?
Yeah, what the fuck, actually.
I think I might pick Love Story. That's fucked.
That's fucked. I don't want to do that. Do you know what? I actually think I'm going to do the same. What the fuck? I don't like that at all. But I think I will choose choose Last Kiss over the Lucky One.
Yeah.
Oh, I wish you would.
I love Jump and Fall.
Say. But I think I'm gonna pick Hiding Places. Yeah,
it just is the better song.
Yeah. Oh, and now I do love I'm Only Me When I'm With You, but I'm gonna pick Jump and Fall. Oh, and then it's
I'm Only Me When I'm With You.
How You Get the Girl, I Knew You Were Trouble. Fuck. Right off.
I have Holy Ground and I Knew You Were Trouble.
I hate it.
I hate it too.
I'm actually going to pick How You Get the Girl. No offense. No, wait, that, am oh, I? Are yeah, you? Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. I love both of them. I am going to pick How You Get the Girl.
That's fucked.
And then I'm going to pick I Knew You Were Trouble. Sorry.
I think I'm going to pick Holy Ground over this one.
Hold the fuck on.
Yeah, that's
fine. It is clean, but I hate it.
That's so criminal to do to you.
That's
so
Oh, begin again. So sorry. Please.
I've always loved Blank Space, but I think Clean has just been bumping up and up and up and up for me. So, yeah. But what do I?
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna pick Clean, but thank it you. Really hurt. Thank you. So and then I'm gonna.
Oh, we got the same.
It's definitely Blank Space for me. And then it's definitely beginning.
I think it is just Blank Space. And then The Best Day and Breathe. I'm gonna pick Breathe.
Yeah, I've got the same. I'm gonna pick The Best Day.
Now I've got The Best Day and Change, I'm going to pick The Best Day.
Thank you. For me, it's Breathe. Oh, now I've got the same.
Yeah. Okay.
I think it's better than Revenge.
Same, actually.
Nice.
Oh, I'm so sorry, but it's Back to December for me.
For me, it's That's When. I fucking love That's When.
That's fair. God, this is where we get hard. You know what? King of My Heart has actually been consistently my favorite song. Actually, that's completely a lie. Getaway Car was my favorite song on Rep for a while. King of My Heart was second. I have decided in the last couple of years that King of My Heart is actually objectively my favorite, and I feel that way today, so I am going to be choosing King of My Heart.
Yeah. It kind of went the opposite for me. King of My Heart was my number one on rep straight away.
Yeah.
And now it's Getaway Car.
So, yeah, Getaway Car and Dress, which, I'm picking... Yeah. Look,
now it's Dress for me.
I actually think I'm going to pick Dress.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, and then I'm... Yeah. I'm definitely picking now Gorgeous. It's I'm so
King
sorry.
Of My Heart for me.
I will never claim to be a Dancing with Our Hands Tied stan because I'm just not. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
I
know how people feel about it. I have been so consistent with saying literally the only version of Dancing with Our Hands Tied that exists is the acoustic version from Rep Tour. That is the only version that exists in my mind. I'm so sorry, but that is the superior
Gorgeous
version.
Is so funny for me. Like, Gorgeous, I will literally be obsessed with Gorgeous, and then I just won't care about it for a few months.
I fully feel the same.
And then, but then, just when I think that I'm like, do I even like this song?
It comes
I fall
back.
In love with it.
Totally. I feel exactly the same.
So I just don't know what to do here, because Dancing With Our Hands Tied, like, it is objectively the better song, in my opinion. Like, I think it has better lyrics than Gorgeous. Like, I loved you in spite of deep fears that the world would divide us.
I know.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to be the ducky representative and I'm going to pick Dancing With Our Hands Tied.
Nice.
Don't even know why, but hey.
I'm going to pick So It Goes over Dancing With Our Hands Tied.
It's Cruel Summer.
Is it?
I think it is. I just can't think about it too much.
I think it is.
Cruel Summer versus Cornelia Street.
I mean... That needs to be Cornelia Street.
Oh, absolutely.
Pick the man, I'm gonna kill you. Okay, thank you. It's Paper Rings. Are you seriously going to pick the man over
No,
Paper
I
Rings?
Will pick Paper
Please,
Rings.
Come
I
on.
I do love the man, Laurie. I'm going to pick the man over Miss Americana.
And I'm going to pick I Think He Knows over Miss Americana.
And then I will also pick I Think He Knows. And you better fucking pick the man.
Yeah, okay, fine, yeah.
Ooh, I forgot that you existed in Miss America.
How many days did I spend thinking about how you did me wrong?
No, I'm going to pick Miss Americana just Same. Because of what she did with the tour.
Yeah.
Oh, I have ready Ooh. For it and the Archer.
Now, honestly, I think that you're lying to yourself if you don't pick Ready for
I
It.
I think I am too, but like...
I know that you have become an Archer stan, but I do think that you prefer Ready for It just Same. Slightly.
No, you're right.
And I'm going to pick Hoax over the Archer. Oh, I'm also going to pick Ready for It over the Archer. Oh!
I'm going to pick the Archer over Hoax.
I need someone to... actually help me. I have
many. Oh my god, you, no, I think that you might need to pick me.
I think I do.
Yeah, it's okay.
That, I'm gonna pick me.
Yeah. I have Lover and Hoax.
Now come on.
I think that I might pick Lover.
Okay.
Now I'll definitely pick Hoax.
Thank you so much.
Oh, me you and just you need to calm just keep down. Going. Me. Yeah, here we go.
Okay, I've got Illicit Affairs and Betty. Now hold your...
Yeah, what the fuck? That's fucked.
Horses!
No, I think it's Betty. You just need to stick with your gut. You love Betty.
I do love Betty, but I don't love Illicit Affairs. I think it's Betty.
It is Betty.
I hate it.
I'm going to do Peace over This Is Me Trying.
Yeah.
Oh, now we've got the opposite.
I think that I'm going to be out here saying that I prefer Illicit Affairs over Peace, which is a lot for me to say, and I actually dislike myself for saying that. But I think it's just how I feel. Are you kidding me? The way that she performs Illicit Affairs on tour? No.
You're right. What do I do about this, though?
I don't know. I'm currently in the same space with This Is Me Trying. That... I think you prefer Betty, okay. Honestly.
Okay. I don't know if that even made sense for what I picked last time, but yeah. And then I'll do This Is Me Trying.
Yeah. And then I think that you need to be picking Mad Woman as well. Yeah, I do. Yeah. And maybe Invisible String maybe too. Like, yeah. I think just keep going. Yeah, cool. I mean, that one's obviously August. Yeah. May as well hit August. Just hit it. It's always
okay,
August.
Okay, I can't do that though.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, yeah. We just need to get you to a point. Yeah. Sometimes when they're so obvious, you just need to keep going because they're obvious. Fuck this one.
Yeah, what the fuck? I don't know. I think that, like, I think that you do. I think you've had more moments with This Is Me Trying.
I think you're right. I think you're right. Now, do you know what? No.
No, that's fuck rude. This.
I hate having to pick anything over Peace. It really makes me so ill. But, like, I think that I'm out here picking Invisible String.
I just like you need to accept that, like, Peace is not one of your stan songs.
Yeah.
Now
I will pick Peace over Mad Woman.
Yeah.
And I will pick Mad Woman over Epiphany, and I will be picking August over My Tears Ricochetti.
But it is My Tears
Ricochetti. It is. And then you know what? It actually is Mirrorball.
It is Mirrorball. Thank God. Oh my God. I was panicking.
And then for me, it's The Lakes.
Yeah, this is the criminal.
No, for you it's Seven. It is. Come Thank on. You. No, it is. Yeah. Oh, we are. Yours is. It's All Too Well 10. It's always you know, All Too Well 10.
No, you need to pick this first and then we'll be on the same.
Help. Exile and Seven? I think I'm going to pick Exile.
I think you are. Yeah, it's okay.
Okay. Yeah. It's All Too Well 10.
It's All Too Well 10.
And it's definitely Cardigan. And it's definitely Last Great American Dynasty. And honestly, it's the one.
Oh, now we've got, for me, this is easy. Dear Reader, Nothing New, Better Man.
Okay. I think I am picking Better Man over I Bet You Think About Me. And then I might be picking I Bet You Think About Me over Dear Reader. And then I'm going to pick Dear Reader over Babe. Dear Reader is a more complex song than Babe.
Yes,
so I'm going to go with that. I am going to say Babe over Nothing New.
Nothing New. No, you kind of like... You're not like a new
Wait,
stan.
Can I listen to Message in a Bottle? I love Nothing New. Do you know what? I actually have something... I have an unpopular opinion, I think, about Nothing New. I think it... And I, you know what? I'm not going to lie. I kind of feel this way about Castles Crumbling as well.
I do feel that way.
Those really deeply vulnerable songs that you know how much Taylor would have felt that... Mm. In the moment that she wrote those songs, I'm like, it throws me off to have another person there
as well. So,
But that still feels different to me because Evermore, like Bonaventure, still wrote for Evermore. Yeah. Like Phoebe and Hayley didn't write for their Vault tracks, and so it throws me off. Like I just think Nothing New would hit me hard. Like honestly, sometimes I listen to Nothing New and I'm so obsessed with the first verse, and then when I get to the second verse, I'm like. It's like I tap out from that, that being like intrinsically tied to Taylor's story. And I think that affects it for me.
I think if it was just Taylor, I would love it even more. But I still love it so much for what it is. I just think that she captured this feeling about women aging in general that I don't feel like anyone else has ever done in that
it's
way.
It's so deeply relatable. And it's why I am so obsessed with that first verse. Because I think that no matter who you are, if you're a woman, you relate to what she's saying there.
I agree.
Like, it's just so good. And it's written in such a vulnerable way. Like, obviously the man holds a similar kind of message about women, but I think because it's a bot, like, sometimes you don't feel the emotion of it as deeply when you're listening to it, but nothing new always hits like that.
Into that first chorus, like, and I know it's sad, but this is what I think about. That, every time, gets me so much in the chest.
Yeah, I get that.
Oh, that beat coming in there is so good. And now I'm standing here hoping it gets to you.
Message in a model, I'm picking it. But what I will say is that I do think that if Max Martin produced it over Elvira, I'd like it even more.
I don't have anti-hero again, guys.
You might just need to make a manual adjustment at the end.
So wait, hang on. I accidentally picked Snow on the Beach over anti-hero.
I think it was regular Snow on the Beach though, and not Mola.
No, I think... Okay, I'm going to pick this. Fuck, I think it's gone. I think anti-hero's gone.
Do you know what, though? Like, guys, we just did our rankings on Patreon of the Eras Tour performances and the Eras Tour outfits. And honestly, like, we ranked them. And then once we finished the ranking, we went back and we were like, do we actually agree with this? Maybe not. Let's make some adjustments. And I think that you can, I think that this is still a space where we can make some slight adjustments. If we just really feel like strongly about it, you can definitely make adjustments for anti-hero at the end.
Okay, I'm going to pick Whenever Falls in
Love. I'm picking Timeless.
Nice.
And then I'm picking Whenever Falls in Love.
I'm going to pick.
I randomly have Lavender Haze here. I'm actually going to pick Foolish One over Lavender Haze, so sorry.
Hate that. I feel like I can see you as, like, it was, like, more of the instant gratification of me loving that song, but I do feel like over time, Timeless is more preferred.
Yeah. I think that's fair. Okay, we both have the same one now.
Shit.
Lavender Haze and I Can See You.
Fuck.
What if I said I prefer Lavender Haze?
No, I hate this one. I hate this one. This makes no sense, this one.
I can see you in your suit and your necktie. That's real. See you meet me tonight. No, I'm so sorry. For me, it's Lavender Haze.
Fuck
it just
off.
Is. Oh my god. I will pick.
I don't know what to do here.
I'm probably going to pick, like, I'm probably going to pick A Perfectly Good Heart over the Ice Spice version of Karma.
Yeah.
So anything will be picked. Thank you. I needed to get the Ice Spice Karma out of the way.
I really hate this. I want to die. I don't want to participate.
Yeah.
But I think I'm going to pick Lavender Haze.
Wow. Yeah.
I know. Then I'll pick I Can See You. Foolish One.
Yeah.
Castle's Crumbling.
Yeah. Okay. Help. Help. Help! What do you mean? Say Don't Go and Electric Touch. I love them both equally.
No,
but I am going to pick
Say
Don't
Go.
Oh my god. No, I feel like I'm going to vomit. I think
Say Don't Go.
I'm going to vomit. But I think it is. Is
no,
It Over
it
Now?
Is, it is. I'm so sorry. It is.
Do you know what? No offense. I am actually going to pick Electric Touch over Slut. Sorry.
Crazy.
And I am going to pick. Oh, we're both at the same one now.
I really hate this one.
I'm going to pick Now That We Don't Talk. Do you know what? I actually really like Suburban Legends.
Don't you dare pick it over Slut. Wait, I need to get that. I'm also going to pick Now That We Don't Talk, but I hate it. And then I'm going to pick Slut. And then obviously Electric Touch. Oh my god, No, I think I like 22 more than I like Suburban Legends.
Do you know what? It's the bridge for me. Like, tick tock on the
actually,
clock.
Actually, maybe I don't.
I paced down your block. I broke my own heart because you were too polite to do it. Waves crashed to the shore. I dashed to the door. You don't knock anymore. And my whole life's ruined. It's so good.
I've never listened to 22, so maybe I will pick Suburban Legends. the fuck did you pick that over? Slut? No, bitch.
I am so sorry, but I actually think Slut is my least favorite 1989 Vault track. And I'm not saying that it's not an incredible song, but I am saying that I gravitate to every other Vault track.
Like, I feel like it kind of tracks for you, just like in terms of energy. But like the bridge is also deeply superior.
I know. I know, and I'm not saying it's not. It just is number five.
This is luxury.
No, I know, but no, I'm sorry.
Okay,
I said what I said. It's Ivy.
Ooh.
It's long story short. For me, it's long story short.
I think that I'm gonna pick Cowboy Like Me, but then I'm gonna pick Long Story Short.
I Wanna Die. Cowboy Like Me and Right Where You Left Me. Yeah. How is a human meant to pick between those songs?
No. I've got Coney Island and Evermore. I've really been doing something with Evermore, yeah, but I think it is Coney Island. And then I'm going to say Evermore. And then I'm going to say Right Where You Left Me. Sorry, I'm wrong. You know what?
I actually might pick Cowboy Like Me.
Yeah, I respect it.
Just, like, slightly.
Yeah. You know, Work With You Fuck is such a good song. Like,
I'm personally, we've both got Gold Rush at the moment and a 1989 song. I'm going to go Gold Rush. I'm out here picking Gold. You know what? I'm actually going to pick, I think You Belong With Me. It's just a classic.
Help! Do I like Gold Rush more than Welcome to New York? See, that, yeah.
I think that you do.
Do well, I?
Do you? You have been having a real moment with Welcome
to New York. I'm sorry. I can't be
You
swayed.
Might be picking Welcome to New York, yeah.
But then
yeah.
I'll pick Gold Rush over Wonderland, yeah. And I will be picking You Belong With Me, and yeah. I will be picking Wonderland, and I will be picking You're Not Sorry.
Okay, so we've both got This Love, and I've got The Way I Loved You, and you've got Treacherous. What the fuck?
I feel like The Way I Loved You is your number one on Fearless.
I think I do maybe prefer it just slightly to This Love, but I do love This Love.
See, I got the same now, and I'm going to pick Treacherous. No questions.
I think I am too, you know? And that...
Ooh.
No, do you know what? This is getting sickening.
Yeah, it's getting sickening. This Love and Tim McGraw and This Love and We're Never Getting Back Together. I think I'm going to pick This Love. I think that maybe you should pick This Love.
Okay. All right. I'll do that.
And then you should pick We're Never Getting Back Together.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So we've both got Out of the Woods. You've got New Romantics and I've got Mean. Now, this is really rude to me, but I am actually going to pick Out of the Woods.
It's Out of the Woods.
And then I'm going to pick Mean.
And then I'm going to put,
And I'm going to pick The Outside.
And I'm going to pick Mean.
And I am going to pick Our Song.
Ooh, A Place in This World and Mean. I've really been having a moment with A Place in This World.
Are you serious? You're actually going to pick...
What?
I'll pick Mean.
I will pick Mean and I will pick Our Song. But then I'm going to pick
A Place in This World. Yeah, okay, cool. I'm going to pick Ours. Well, yeah. Oh!
Well, no.
Yeah, right. I'm probably lying.
Yeah.
I am going to pick Ours now,
the
though.
The fuck?
Yeah. And then I'm going to pick Mine. And then I'm going to pick New Romantics. Good. And then I do like The Moment I Knew, I'm going to pick The Moment I Knew. I am going to pick A Place in This World. Yeah. And I am going to... Do you know what? As long as Never Grow... I do like Never Grow Up, but it isn't one of my favorite songs. Yeah. Like... Now, hold on a second. Never Grow Up with a Perfectly Good Heart. Maybe I need to just be pausing for a moment. Yeah, pause there.
Ooh, The Moment I Knew and The Outside. These are not my favorite songs. I think I might be needing to be listening.
While we're here, I am going to pick Never Grow Up over a Perfectly Good Heart. Good. You've never been a big The Moment I Knew stan.
No, I'm not. I don't know why. It's very slow. And it was like
slow motion. It's meant to be like slow motion. This is how slow it felt for her to fathom that this motherfucker wasn't coming to her 21st birthday party.
The Outside.
Cool. Guys, this is taking us so long. We're actually going to do a bit of this off camera.
Yeah.
And then as we start getting towards the end of it.
Well, maybe we should get to 80% and then turn the camera back on.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Guys, we'll see you at 80%. Guys, I just had to put the camera on for this.
We're only at 60%, but
I have Say Don't Go and Bejeweled, and I literally have no idea. I think so I need to play them.
What are you going to do? Say Don't Go and Bejeweled.
I feel sick. I feel actually sick. This is not okay.
I just had to choose between Bejeweled and Is It Over Now, and I actually feel sick because I chose Bejeweled because it's like... But I actually think Is It Over Now. Oh, I can't. I actually can't.
This song just does something to me. I cannot believe she didn't put this on 1989 the first time. I find it so insulting to my well-being.
I think you might need to pick Say Don't Go. But I picked Bejeweled. I regret my choice. I wish I picked Is It Over Now.
You know what? I think it is, but not many things are going. No, I've got Is It Over Now. Yes, yeah, No offense, it's Bejeweled.
It is.
But then, what the fuck? Is It Over Now in question?
Is It Over Now?
It is. Okay, fine.
Timeless. It's
very difficult.
No, it's timeless.
Okay, fine.
It's When Everyone Falls in Love.
Yeah, you're right.
It's Electric Touch.
But that's your opinion.
No,
isn't
on
my
yours,
opinion?
On your opinion, on how you feel. I do feel that that is what you feel.
You think I prefer? You think I'm out here living like Electric Touch is better than Question? I don't know about that.
I think you
I
are.
I love Question. Good girl, sad boy, big city, wrong choices. We had one thing going on. I swear that it was something, because I don't.
Well, I have
remember who
I have
was
Electric Touch and Karma, and I'm struggling.
Color I've searched for since. I actually think that yours is Karma.
I think it is. You're right. Thank you. I needed help.
Yeah. What if I said I'm choosing Question over Electric Touch? I think I am.
Okay, that's fine. I get it.
Now what if I said I'm choosing Electric Touch over Anti?
That's not right. I mean, maybe it is for you.
I do love Antihero. No, I think I'm being a silly chicken. I'm going Antihero.
Okay, good.
And then I will say Electric Touch.
Now, the challenge is really picking things up a notch.
So we're at 74%. We decided to turn the camera on now because it just was getting really difficult and we felt like you needed to be seeing the deliberations.
I have Out of the Woods and State of Grace. Now, State of Grace is probably my favorite on Red, but Out of the Woods is not my favorite on 1989.
Sometimes I don't think that matters, though. Like, you could still prefer a song on 1989 more than your favorite song on Red.
Fine. I think it's Out of the Woods.
I think that that's Long Live. Look, I have Clean and Ivy, and...
It's Ivy. Is it? Or are you going to change your top three?
The thing is that Clean has so consistently been one of my tops, and, like... With time pass, I'm like, maybe I do actually just want Clean to be slightly above Ivy.
Maybe you do.
Clean just means too much. I think I'm actually going to go Clean. I am surprised at myself.
Wow.
But I will be saying Ivy now. Mm. No!
Out of the Woods, or Long Story Short.
I think it has to be Out of the Woods.
I feel like it has to be Haunted.
It's Haunted. It is.
I think it's Begin Again.
I think it is. Now I might actually go Long Story Short.
Yeah.
I need to ponder on that. We need to go to you.
Blank Space or Treacherous? I think it might be Treacherous.
I mean, it could be, yeah.
Like, it's so hard because Blank Space, like, I go through phases where I listen to Blank Space so much and I have just an absolute mental breakdown. Like, I think you guys know every time I talk about Blank Space, I just have a conniption.
That's true.
Because I don't understand how she wrote such a perfect song.
Yeah.
But sometimes I also do the same thing with Treacherous. So I feel like I just have to go off what I'm feeling today.
Yeah.
And today I'm feeling Treacherous.
Cool.
This is so fucked. I'm also going to pick Cowboy Like Me.
Sometimes you just have to, like, sit with how fucked it is and just deal with it regardless.
It's so criminal. Blank Space or Long Story Short?
I don't even know. I honestly don't even know with you. Maybe it is Blank Space. You do love Blank Space a lot.
I do love Blank Space. Oh, my God. Fearless or Long Story Short? I think it is Long Story Short.
Yeah.
Champagne Problems. Red. Okay, yeah, this is feeling good.
All right, let's just switch back over to me. I think I'm going to choose You're Losing Me over Enchanted.
Oh, wow, yeah.
I know, that's a lot. help.
Champagne problems are enchanted.
I think it's champagne problems. Yeah. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, red. It's red.
I think you're right. Yeah.
The story of us.
No, enchanted has always been above the story of us for me.
Now it's the story of us.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think I'm lying if I say it's anything but long live.
Okay, I love that. I'm actually going to be very happy with all long live climbing up on your list.
Yeah, and I'm so sorry, but...
Fuck off. Is it really?
I mean... Yeah.
Okay, fine.
You know what? Yep. All right, we'll leave. I mean, let's be real. I'm going to pick Cowboy Like Me now.
And
okay.
Style.
I mean,
am I really going to pick... Maybe not. Okay. Style and fearless. I do love me some fearless.
You do love fearless. I feel like you like fearless more.
I really love fearless. That's so fucked. Style or begin again? Oh, I just want to cry. I actually want to cry. I think it might be style.
I was going to say, yeah.
And then I think I'm going to pick You Are
Unloved. Yeah, I think that feels right for you. I might even say Hits Different.
Maybe Hits Different.
Yeah. I'll answer you that
Coney
one
Coney Island or Begin Again?
Nah, that's where I fall I off. I don't know.
I think I'm going to pick Coney Island. But okay. Then I think I might pick Begin Again.
Okay.
And then I'm going to pick Evermore.
Yep.
Right Where You Left Me. Marjorie. Enchanted. It's Time to Go.
Beautiful.
That's all I can do.
I think I simply have to be choosing style. Yeah. Let's be real.
I think it might be The Way I Loved You.
I think you're right.
You know, that's really quite interesting to fathom.
I know. I'm also going to be out here picking Right Where You Left Me.
Treacherous,
yeah. Oh. It is this love. Let's be real. I think it's Coney Island. Mm. And then I think it's The Last Time. Mm. And I need to stop there.
Okay. New Romantics or Willow? It might be Willow.
I think it is.
Maybe then New Romantics.
Yep.
But then maybe Happiness. I think I'm going to go This Love. I think I'm going to go Dorothea. I think I'm going to go Sad, Beautiful, Tragic. Tis the Damn Season. Sparks Fly. The Best Day. I Wish You Would. The Last Time.
I'm going to say I know places, you know? Mm-hmm. I'm going to say We're Never Getting Back Together. It's simply Wildest Dreams, and it's Hits Different. I love Forever and Always. As I said, it is my second favorite song on Fearless, but like there are also just so many songs that have come out since Fearless that I prefer. So, you know, oh God, Fearless is a good song, isn't it? I actually think I'm going to pick Fearless.
Nice.
And Blank Space is Blank Space. Dear John, I have to go with it. I'm so sorry, but
now
I do.
You're not sorry, maybe.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I know places, and Welcome to New York. I'm sorry, I love Welcome to New York at the moment. I know what you want me to do. Maybe Gold Rush? Help. You Belong With Me or I Know Places?
I think it's You Belong With Me.
I feel bad for I Know Places. I'm going to pick I Know Places now.
Yeah.
Holy Ground.
Nice.
Hey, Steven.
Nice. Yeah.
Forever and Always Piano Version. Mean. Yeah. Our Song. Last Kiss. Fuck!
I think it's Jump Then Fall.
Jump Then Fall. Tim McGraw.
Yep.
I really like Nobody No Crime.
Yep. Superman. I'm just really having to make a split second decision and like not think too hard about it. I don't even know if I agree with it all, but that's where I'm at currently.
I think it might be You Are In Love. Yeah. Sad, Beautiful, Tragic.
Yeah.
Nobody No Crime.
Yeah. Yeah.
Last
Kiss. It does have to be Last Kiss. I do love Everything Has Changed, and I do love Breathe, and I do love Forever and Always, the piano version, and I do like mine. Jump Then Fall is a good song. I'm Only Me When I'm With You, yes. New Romantics is New Romantics. And Hey Steven is Hey Steven. And Come In With The Rain. And honestly, it does have to be Holy Ground if I'm serious with myself. I think that I do like on debut Cold As You a bit more than Tied Together With A Smile. So I'm going to do that.
Now you're going to go.
I think I'm going to, and then I think I have to go You Belong With Me, Superstar, Untouchable,
Wonderland,
yeah,
Tolerated,
yeah,
Speak Now.
I mean, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, fuck me. Yeah, Sparks Fly.
Yeah.
Should have said no.
Yeah. Shake It Off is Shake It Off.
The White Horse.
Yeah. Oh, it's Welcome to New York. I mean, it really is just Closure. I think I prefer The Best Day Over Starlight.
I'm stating my stance on. The Moment I Knew For You.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I think I'm going to be crazier.
Yeah, okay.
Eyes Open, Girl at Home.
You prefer Eyes Open over Safe and Sound?
I think I do. I'm having a moment.
Wow.
I actually just think I'm delirious, but I've been really having a moment with the...
Yeah, that's fair.
Safe and Sound. Oh, okay. Here we go.
I mean,
here
it's...
Here we go.
For both of us, it's All Too Well
10.
It's August. It is Cardigan.
I have a new addition here. You're on your own, kid. I think I'm going to pick it.
I think I'm going to pick All You Have to Do Is Stay. But I actually do think that these days I prefer You're on Your Own, Kid over Death by a Thousand Cuts. So I'm actually going to do that. And honestly, if I'm being honest with myself, I might feel that same way about Maroon.
Fair.
So I'm going to do it.
I think I'm going to have to pick Cardigan.
I think that feels right.
I think I'm going to pick Getaway Car. And then My Tears Ricochet. And then Maroon. And then... Death by a Thousand Cuts, and then Delicate, and then Peace.
I think it's Mirable.
Yeah, I think it is.
And I think it's Seven.
What is? Do I pick Seven over Cruel Summer?
I mean, I think that that's how you feel. Yeah, that would be my guess for you, for sure. Yeah.
Okay. Bejeweled and Cruel Summer.
That's sickening. That's about as sickening as this.
I think that, well, you know what's interesting is you've ranked You're On Your Own, Kid as your top midnight song.
Yeah, I think I might have at this point.
Which is not in line with what you say.
Well, but that's why we do this, right? Because what we feel is always going to be a bit different from when we're actually doing a proper, like, this is like a logistical ranking. And they do often come out differently.
They do, yeah.
To how you think you feel about something.
I know. Oh my god, I feel ill. I feel so ill. I feel sick. I think I have to say New Year's Day.
Yeah.
And Cornelius Street.
Yeah.
You know what? I am going to say So I Go Now.
Yeah.
And I am going to say Whenever Falls in Love. Yeah. I'm going to say
The Wall. Wow. Okay. And I think you need to say The Great War. Thank you.
Okay. Maybe I'll pick Daylight Now.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. But then we're going to go back to Snow on the Beach.
Yeah.
And I think we're going to do Nothing New.
Yeah.
And I think we're going to do Now That We Don't Talk. And we're going to do The Lakes. We're going to do Woulda, Coulda, Shoulda. We are going to do Better Man.
I am so mind blown. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Timeless or False God?
I think you might prefer Timeless.
I think I might. Thank you. I think maybe it's I Think He Knows.
I think you're right. Yeah. And then it is You All Over Me. And then I think it might be The Archer.
Okay.
And then I think it might be False God.
I'm really proud of you for picking those over.
Do you know what? I'm also having a moment with Epiphany again, to be honest. I'm going to pick Epiphany.
Okay.
And I am going to pick Message in a Bottle. And then I am going to pick Nothing New. Good.
I think you need to pick Lavender Haze.
Afterglow. No.
I'll
pick Lavender Haze now. And I'll pick I Can See You, Slut, The Man, Lover.
Ooh, what are you going to do there?
Miss Americana.
Oh, are you? Okay. Ooh. I really don't like The Very First Night.
No, The Very First Night doesn't do a lot for me either.
I think I'm going to pick It's Nice to Have a Friend.
Yeah, sometimes it can kind of go off. Like, La pink sky, up on the roof, sun sinks down, no curfew. It kind of goes off sometimes. Oh, yeah, you need to be making a decision here. Yep. You need to be making a decision.
Guys, is You're On Your Own, Kid, has it overtaken Ivy?
I wouldn't be surprised if it has, honestly.
I think that right now it... I think that maybe it has.
Yeah, I think that's
but
valid.
But then I'm still going to do Ivy.
Ah! No, long story short, and The Last Great American Dynasty is not okay, but I am actually going to pick Long Story Short.
Oh my god! You're just powering through it.
Oh my god, what the fuck? What the fuck is this? You're losing me and The Last Great American Dynasty?
You need to tap into the soul for this one.
Hello, can we be a set song? I think we're going to pick The Last Great American Dynasty.
That's fine. That's okay. Delicate. Peace. Out of the Woods, Long Live, Mirrorball, State of Grace, Seven, Cruel Summer,
Clean. It just gets to a point where you're doing so many things and I can't, my brain is struggling to keep up.
I feel
up.
So ill.
I like it. We're trying to just power through we're going with the real gut instinct, which I think it's a good way to do it because that we could literally sit here for like 3 days trying to figure this out. And then it's Death by a Thousand Cuts.
Is it?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Honestly, fucking Say Don't Go! Yeah! Say Don't Go! And then I am getting it!
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna get Mirrorball.
Okay, wow. This is a state of grace.
I'm gonna go State of Grace.
Really?
And I'm gonna go Cover Like Me.
Wow.
I'm gonna go Down You With Trouble.
Yeah, wow. Maybe you like Mean.
And I'm gonna go Delicate.
Oh shit.
And I'm gonna go Hoax. Oh, and I'm gonna go Ready For It. I'm gonna go Style. I need to leave it there.
Okay.
We're gonna get a Say Don't Go!
Oh, you know what? I'm gonna do Say Don't Go.
Okay, well.
Whenever Falls in Love. Yes, come on.
Okay.
Okay, now I'll do Begin Again.
Yep.
Evermore.
Yep.
Right Where You Left
Me. I think so. Yeah, Marjorie. I think it's Marjorie. I think it is.
I'm going to go Dear Reader.
Okay. Oh, wow. Okay.
The Great War. Last Game of Thrones. Daylight.
Oh, God. I feel ill.
Enchanted.
Wow.
Snow on the Beach.
Wow.
Nothing New or It's Time to Go.
It might be Nothing New for you.
It might be. I do love It's Time to Go, though. I'm going to do It's Time to Go, and then I'm going to do Willow. Now let me talk. Okay, I need to stop. I actually feel ill. I don't even know what I just did. I just literally just made the worst decisions.
Yeah, no. I know it's a lot. I think I'm going to go The Way I Loved You. I'm going to go Right Where You Left Me. Mm. I'm going to go Treacherous. I'm going to go
This Love.
I'm going to go Break My Soul in Two. Looking for you, but you're right here. I think I might go Coney Island. I am going to go Better Man. No offense, but I'm going Whenever Falls in Love. I am having more of a moment with Question right now, so I'm going Question. Are you really about to pick Castles Crumbling Over the Outside? Please, come on. Really? Oh my God, I can't. I actually cannot.
Guys, I'm being crazier over the Ice Spice feature, which is actually a lot. I kind of like the facts. I'm going to pick that. Eyes Open, Girl at Home, Safe and Sound, The Moment I Knew, Invisible, Change, A Perfectly Good Heart.
Oh my God, you're done. Okay. Oh, God.
We were happy.
I actually really just don't like We Were Happy. I'm actually going to go A Perfectly Good Heart. I'm done.
Wow, we did really well. Okay.
Wow, this is a lot looking at.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Okay, so we both have All Too Well 10.
Yeah.
We both have August.
Yeah.
I have You're On Your Own Kid, and you have Cardigan.
Yeah.
I have Ivy as number 4, and you have
Clean. And I have Ivy as number 5.
And I have Cardigan.
Yeah, okay.
So our top 5 are kind of similar, except you have Clean and I have You're On Your Own Kid. I feel pretty good about my top 5. I'm just going to rattle off my next ones. Then I have You're Losing Me, Getaway Car, Wildest Dreams, My Tears Ricochet, and Maroon. Oh my God, that's my top 10.
Yeah, and then I have All You Had to Do Was Stay, Out of the Woods, You're On Your Own Kid, Haunted, and Begin Again. That feels right for me.
Yeah.
That does feel right. Do you want to tell us your 11 to 20?
Okay, so my 11 to 20 is Death by a Thousand Cuts, Delicate, Peace, Out of the Woods, Long Live, Mirrorball, State of Grace as my first red song coming in.
Well, other than All Too Well 10.
Sorry, yes. 7, Cruel Summer, Clean, cracked the top 20.
Wow, yeah, there you go. That's a lot. That's a big climb for Clean for you.
It is. Well, I did say that when I heard it again with 1989, I had a whole moment. But then also it's just been a really relevant song for me the last 6 months. I've really used that song a lot. So it makes sense that it's climbed up a bit for me.
So my 11 to 20 is Maroon, Long Story Short, The Last Great American Dynasty, My Tears Ricochet, High Infidelity, Would've, Could've, Should've, You're Losing Me, Champagne Problems, Death by a Thousand Cuts, and Say Don't Go.
Yeah, I love that.
Now, it is interesting because, yeah, we've got You're On Your Own Kid and Maroon above High Infidelity, which, like, honestly, like, maybe that is the truth. I just... Maybe that's just it. But I do feel good about the fact that we've got High Infidelity, Would've, Could've, Should've, and You're Losing Me all still in my top 20 because I just think that that's right.
My 21 to 30, Treacherous, Ready For It, Cowboy Like Me, Blank Space, Long Story Short, Champagne Problems, Red, Fearless, Style, and Bejeweled.
I feel like that feels good.
I like it. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good.
The only thing that's just missing so far is probably Anti-Hero.
You know what? That would be in my top 20.
Yeah,
that
so you'll just need to see... you'll just need to see where you'd want to slot it in. And guys, what we're going to do is we will create our relevant playlist for this and we will link them below as well so that you can see the final result, especially if you were going to make an amendment with Anti-Hero. So you just need to figure out where you think Anti-Hero slots in nicely. I think I would
put Anti-Hero at number 16 in between Long Live and Mirrorball.
I think that's fair. All right, so my 21 to 30 is Mirrorball, Back to December, Bejeweled, Red, King of My Heart, Getaway Car, Cruel Summer, Is It Over Now, Enchanted, and Betty.
Nice. Oh, Betty made it in the top 30.
Betty made it in the top 30.
Good.
Yeah. Okay, so you're 31 to 40.
Yes. Okay, I have Is It Over Now, Dress, King of My Heart, The Archer.
Wow, Dress is over King of My Heart.
Yeah, it is.
Wow. Okay, cool.
I guess it's just, I feel like they're on the same page.
Yeah, me. I get that. I do.
Don't Blame Me.
Yeah.
Oh God, I've been having such a moment. Don't Blame Me. You Are In Love. Yeah, that feels good. Hits Different. Okay.
Yeah.
New Year's Day. Coney Island and Cornelia Street.
Yeah.
These are just some superior songs.
They are. Now, hold on a second. I haven't even had Hits Different yet. I am very curious to see where Hits Different has ended up. My 31 to 40 is The Story of Us, Long Live, Timeless, How You Get the Girl, Cornelia Street, Illicit Affairs, I Wish You Would, State of Grace, Cowboy Like Me, and I Knew You Were Trouble.
I feel like from Betty down to like How You Get the Girl is just such an Emily list of songs.
Yeah, right. Betty, that. The Story of Us,
Long Live, Affairs really has made it in there, hasn't it?
Yeah, and I've been feeling this for a few months that it probably would. All right, 41 to 50.
Yeah, there's some superior songs in here, I'm not going to lie. Say Don't Go.
Yeah.
When Emma Falls in Love.
Yeah, wow.
Begin Again.
Yep.
Evermore.
Yep.
Right Where You Left Me.
Yep.
Marjorie. Dear Reader. The Great War. The Last Great American Dynasty, and Daylight. Can I just say, Enchanted and Everything Has Changed is next, so Everything Has Changed has just missed my top 50.
Yeah,
I'm not sure how I feel about that. But you know, there's just so many superior songs.
That's the thing, there's so many songs that sometimes you think a song can be like in your top and then you realize that you actually do love 50 songs more.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It is. Okay, so my 41 to 50 is Mean, Delicate, Hoax, Ready For It, Style, The Way I Loved You, Right Where You Left Me, Treacherous, This Love, and Coney Island's number 50.
Yes.
And then we've got songs like just after that, A Better Man, When Emma Falls in Love, Question. And then I can also see now that Hits Different has actually come in at number 66, which is crazy. I thought it would be a lot higher than that. I feel good about the fact that there are so many songs above it that I know I love so much that it just is correct. Anyway, should we reveal the bottom 10?
Yeah, I just want to make sure. I did definitely say 7 made it into my top 50, didn't it? Yes. Yes, good. And so did Mirrorball. Nice. Yes, good.
Nice, good. Yeah. Oh my fucking God.
This is just so curious, isn't it? There's so many superior songs in the middle here that just aren't in the top 50, and that just hurts my soul.
So there's 210 songs. So I guess it's 210 to 200 if we're working backwards.
Karma is your last one.
Karma featuring Ice Spice is the bottom. Yeah. I think that's pretty valid. And then I'm going to go from bottom up.
Yeah.
So Karma is my least favorite. And then we've got We Were Happy, Tracks, A Perfectly Good Heart. Yep. Soon You'll Get Better, I Never Listen To. Beautiful Eyes, Eyes Open. Bye Bye Baby, yeah, it's never really done a lot for me. Mm. It's Nice to Have a Friend. You Need to Calm Down.
That's very low.
Mary's Song and Innocent.
Yeah. I have Beautiful Eyes, I Heart ? A Perfectly Good Heart. I feel like those three just being at the bottom just makes sense for me. I don't listen to those three songs.
Yeah.
Then I have Change, which is
that kind of tracks for you.
Mary's Song, I'm so sorry to offend. It's not my favorite. Invisible, The Moment I Knew, oh my God, that's a lot. Safe and Sound, Girl at Home, Eyes Open, Karma Remix.
Yeah.
Crazier. Wow, Mary's Song is both quite low for both of us.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I do like that song. I just, it's never really done a huge amount for me.
And to hear is at 152. That's just not right.
Wow. I can't believe we've redone this. This is so crazy. Like seeing those midnights, you know, the 1989 Vault tracks really came in. They really came in there and did something there.
They did.
Say Don't Go is my number 20. Damn. I respect that placement, honestly. That's a good ass song.
Yeah, that actually made sense. You did say that it might crack that for you.
Yeah.
I think that my top Vault song is It Over Now, and it was at number 30. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this because I didn't.
No, there's definitely a pain that comes with this, which is definitely unenjoyable. But really I will say that I am very happy to have it done now and just to know that we're sorted. We've got the top 50 happening.
Yep.
It's fine. I would love for you guys to comment below and tell us your top 10 and maybe your bottom 10 songs as well. Yeah. That would be really fascinating for us to see.
And I can't believe that the next time we see you, we're going to be sitting down to film our reaction to Tortured Poets.
Guys, so, that's the next video in just a few days.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, that's so sickening. I can't believe we're going to listen to Tortured Poets so soon. I cannot believe it's so close.
I'm so ready for a new album.
I think I'm going to like hyperventilate and die when we're reacting. Like, I think I'm going to forget how to breathe.
I think that it's just
what
like,
is oxygen?
I can't believe the last new album we got was Midnights, and that was so exciting. And now
and
this
we were
is
in
even
Paris.
More, I know.
We're so happy to be home for this new album reaction as well.
God.
Like, Midnight in Paris was such an incredible experience, but there's nothing quite like reacting to a new Taylor album in the comfort of your own home.
Deeply necessary.
Especially when you're on the verge of a
Deeply
mental breakdown.
Necessary.
So,
yeah.
you know, it
oh
just be like that. Guys, we will see you then.
Bye.
Bye.